Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me this afternoon is Julie Stephenson from BioSig Technologies. Julie, good to see you again. How are you?
I'm good, Christine. Thanks for the opportunity to meet again.
Of course. Yeah, great to have you back. And from my understanding, BioSig Technologies Pure EP 2.0 study results have been published in the Journal of Cardiovascular Electrophysiology. Could you share some of the key findings of that study with us?
I'd be happy to. So the Pure EP 2.0 study is a prospective multi-center study in which 235 signal data sets were analyzed from 51 patients who underwent ablation procedures. In this study, all types of ablation procedures were represented. So we had atrial fibrillation, VT, PVC, and atrial flutter procedures in this cohort. The study method required the collection of matching intracardiac signals of clinical interest from three systems in the EP lab during each procedure. And those three systems were, of course, the Pure EP system, the recording system, and the mapping system. These signal samples were then randomized and subjected to blinded head-to-head analysis by three independent electrophysiologists who'd never used the Pure EP system. We then analyzed the results from the blinded panel, and we saw 93% consensus in their ratings of the signals. So this is practically unheard of, to have three physicians give you consistent responses in signal analysis is really incredible to see. And it shows the strong consistency in our results. So overall, the study results validate the clinical relevance of the Pure EP system. And we saw a cumulative 75% improvement in signal quality and physician confidence in interpreting Pure EP signals over conventional sources of signals. Further, the analysis of the results revealed that there was an 83% improvement in confidence when interpreting complex multi-component signals with a p-value of less than 0.001. This improvement leads to better understanding of the catheter position in relation to the ablation target inside the heart. Additionally, there was also a 73% improvement in visualization of small fractionated signals of clinical interest, again, with a p-value of less than 0.001. And this increases the proper analysis of scar and abnormal conduction tissue inside the heart. So these results exceeded our expectations on both signal quality and clinical relevance. And I am so pleased to be here today discussing them with you.
So you say that the results do validate the relevance here. What might it mean for physicians and patients?
Yeah, so first of all, this, as it relates to physician and patients, the cardiac signal information is a critical factor in successfully diagnosing and treating all cardiac arrhythmias. Intracardiac signals for ablation procedures are one of the most important inputs driving physician decisions. And so with these study results, we can now say that Pure EP represents a new standard in signal acquisition and processing technology, and it provides superior physiologic cardiac signals over conventional systems on the market. We routinely hear from the physicians who are using the Pure EP system that it makes them feel more confident, and it makes them more efficient. And this is great news for patients and hospitals. I just want to add that this publication, in my mind, represents a watershed moment for BioSig Technologies. In order for any new medical technology to be widely adopted and accepted, we need strong prospective clinical study results, like the ones we have with the Pure EP 2.0 study.
So in your view, what are now the next steps BioSig will take now that you have seen this data published?
Yeah, so we'll be very busy working with our physician investigators to disseminate these study results to the EP community. We've already got a variety of educational and marketing activities scheduled. So that's an important next step. But all of the other strategic commercial, clinical, and R&D activities at BioSig Technologies will continue in earnest. So our strategic plans are sound. And we currently have Pure EP systems installed in 13 centers and have over 1,400 Pure EP procedures under our belt. We've got numerous other system installations scheduled in the next few months with interest in the PureEP technology continuing to grow. Additionally, we have already finished enrollment in our next clinical study. It's called the Redo AFib study. An analysis on that data is currently ongoing. Furthermore, we've expanded use of the PureEP system to physiologic pacing procedures, and we're testing the utility of advanced signal processing in that particular type of procedure, which could expand the use of PureEP beyond ablation procedures. And lastly, the PureEP product development is ongoing. Many enhancements that we can make to the system, and we anticipate our next software release happening sometime in Q1 next year.
So here's the question that investors want to know. What does this clinical data mean for future sales?
Great question. This peer review publication is extremely important on our commercial front. As we expand our footprint into more hospital centers, supporting clinical data is often requested as hospitals make purchasing decisions. So the compelling PureEP 2.0 study results and the publication will certainly help accelerate our commercialization of the PureEP system. It'll be a great advantage to us to have these results in hand as we go to hospital administrators.
Good to hear, Julie. Always great to speak with you. Thanks again.
Likewise. Great to see you. Take care.